I'll come along then to Portimão, one of the busiest towns in the Algarve, and a breathtaking destination that brings tourists from all around the world to the shores of southern Portugal. Today it's the backdrop for the latest round of the Formula One World Championship, and with a circuit this wide, we could be in for a lot of exciting wheel-to-wheel action today. 2.9 miles of track at Portimão featuring 15 turns, 9 to the right and 6 to the left. There's a lot going on here, a lot of elevation changes that will affect the driver's braking and acceleration. Keep an eye out for the DRS zone on the final straight. That will be the setup for a lot of today's overtaking chances. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Hamilton, Carlos Sainz, and Norris, Ricciardo, Leclerc, Gasly, and Yuki Tsunoda, Fernando Alonso, Vettel, Esteban Ocon, Potter, Stroll, Russell, Kimi Raikkonen, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Mick Schumacher, Piquet, Latifi, and Nikita Mazepin. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
great maneuver. You made it look easy. This lap, we can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. We're leading our teammate by 11.1 seconds. Gap to car in front is 2.6 seconds. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. The car behind is catching you by 5/10 a lap. 5/10. Okay, gap ahead is 5.0 seconds. Start losing some tire grip around now. Push now. We're boxing this lap. Go. Look after these tires now. We want to finish the race on this compound. throw in the pits. Job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Our gap to the car in front is 2.5 seconds. Pace is strong, but be aware your tyres need to go the distance. 5 laps of fuel remaining. Some information on Ricciardo. They are out of the race. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. Green flag. Was far too aggressive. Clean passes only. We don't want a penalty. Got 2 laps of fuel left. Thank you. race. Gap to teammate behind is 43.3 seconds. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. The end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
It was a magnificent race and a drive right out of the top draw to take the win for Red Bull today. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalize on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. More points for Valtteri Bottas, further solidifying his lead at the top of the table. Some amazing talents out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Potter. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Red Bull take over as championship leaders. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.